Hello children, welcome to today's session. I hope everyone completed your activities in studio. Okay, so today in this session we can learn quick tips how to subtract the numbers, okay, and also the word problems. Okay, can I everyone take your studio, take pencil along with you. Children, take your book, page number 27. See here, in which place has the digit changed in the answer? Okay, so this one I gave home fun in the last session, isn't it? Yes. So in here, in which place has the digit changed in the answer, Kanna? Yes, very good. Tens place. Okay, because we are adding 10 alone to this number, so the answer is changing in the tens place. Very good. Super. Here, in which place has the digit is changed in the answer? Here we are adding 100 to that number. So which place the answer is changed? Yes, very good. Hundreds place. Yes. Okay, so you have to put the tick option for that hundreds place. Next, we are going to see the subtract the following numbers. So we have added. Okay, here now we are going to do the subtraction. So 234 minus 10 means you are going to subtract 1 from the tens place. Okay. So you write 1 tens 100, Kana. Then subtract 1 from the tens place. So here we are having 3 tens. If you subtract 1, yes, we will be having 2 tens. Very good. So what will be the answer? 224. Okay. So the number in ones place and hundreds place remains same. And in tens place alone, you will be reducing the number because you will subtract 1. Okay, Kanna? Yes. So the remaining sums you do by yourself. Okay. So same way here. 100 we are subtracting. So 234 minus 100 means what you have to do? Yes, you want to subtract 1 from the hundreds place. Okay. You want to subtract 1 from the hundreds place. So in ones place, write the number as it is. And tens place also same number will be coming. And here in 100 you are having 2. Okay. So 2 minus 1. Yes. Very good. 1. Okay. So 134. Okay, Kanna. So like that you want to subtract 1 from the hundreds place. Like that you want to do the remaining sums. Okay. And see here, Kanna. In which place has the digit changed in the answer? Okay, so here in which place the digit is changed? Yes, very good. Tens place. Super. Here we are subtracting 100. So subtracting 100 means the digit changed in the hundreds place. Super, Kanna. Now see here, Kanna. Take your book, page number 28. See one example they have given. 235 plus 500. Okay, so they have added the number 500 and see what is the answer came? 735. So you want to skip forward 5 times. Okay, so already we have learned tens skip counting, isn't it? 10, 20, 30, isn't it? Yes, like that. Here we are skip counting in hundreds. So 100, 200, 300. Isn't it? Like that until 500 you want to skip forward. Okay. So here 235. So with the 235 you want to add 100. Okay. You will be getting 335. So in quick tips we have learned. Isn't this? If you are adding 100 to this number, it will become 335. And they are asking until 500. Okay. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So until 500 if you added, at the last what is the answer? 735. Okay, Kanna, that is the answer we will be getting. Okay, so you have to skip count in hundreds. Okay, but see here how many hundred they gave? 500 alone they gave, Kanna. So you can skip count in 500s alone. Okay, see here, since we are adding 500s, we skip count 5 times forward in hundreds. Okay, so skip count in hundreds. We are moving forward 5 times. So, we will be getting the answer. Okay, so in the same way, see they have given the number 526 minus 300. So minus means you want to skip count backward. Okay, see they have given 526. So you want to move backward. Skip count 100 only. But how many 100? 300. So first time, two time, three times. So 300, three times you want to come backward. Okay, if you come backward, you will be getting the answer 226. Okay, Kanna, see here. Since we are subtracting 300, we skip count three times backward. Okay, so 300 means minus here they are asking. So you want to subtract means you want to skip count three times backward. Okay, so addition means you want to skip count forward. Forward. Okay, subtraction means you want to skip count backward. And how many 100 they gave? Based on that you want to skip count. Here 300 means 3 times. Okay, suppose 200 means 2 times alone you can skip count. Okay, Kanna? See here we can see one example. 426 plus 200. So 200 means how many times you want to skip, Kanna? Yes, very good. 2 times. Yes, either forward or backward. Yes, very good, Kanna. Forward, because here plus symbol is there. Okay, so here plus symbol is there. So you want to skip count forward. Okay, so 426. If you are adding 100 means it will become 526. Okay, and again one more 100. This is one time. Okay, 100 we have added and 200 you want to add. So one more 100 if you are adding means it will become 626. So two times you want to skip forward. Okay, Kanna? Yes. Now what is the answer? 626 is the answer. Okay. Yes. Now see here, Kanna. For subtraction we can do the one sum. 672 minus 200. Okay. So minus 200 means whether we want to skip count forward or backward. Yes, very good. Backward. Okay, so first you want to write the number 672 and you want to skip count 100. How many times? Yes, very good. 2 times, because 200 we are having. So 2 times alone you want to skip backward. Okay, subtraction means backward. Okay, so if you subtract 100 you will be getting 572. And if you subtract another 100 means you will be getting 472. So now what is the answer we got, Kanna? Yes, 472. Okay, so 472. So you are skip counting backward. Okay, Kanna, it's the time for home fun. Take your companion book, page number 9. Okay, 8A is the home fun for you, Kanna. Add the following sets of numbers. So you want to add the numbers. Okay, and second one, subtract the following sets of numbers. Okay, so you want to add these numbers and here you want to subtract the numbers. Okay, so next take page number 10. 8B is the home fun for you. Fill in the blanks by skip counting in hundreds. Okay, so skip counting in hundreds you want to add. Here you want to draw, Kanna. So 200 means how many times you will skip count? 2 times. Yes, either forward or backward. Yes, very good. Forward. Okay, so plus addition means forward, subtraction means backward. Okay, Kanna. So in this space you want to draw. Okay, so complete this home fun and upload in the Kensi lab, Kanna. Okay, yes. Now see, Kanna, next we are going to see the Think and Ink activity 8.6, page number 29. Okay, take your studio, page number 29, and see here the fruits are kept in different boxes. Okay, so they have kept the fruits in different boxes. Add them to find the total number of fruits. Okay, so they are asking to find the total number of fruits. Total means you want to add all the fruits. Okay. So how many apples are there, Kana? See here in this box, apple picture they have given. So how many apples are there? 234 apples. So 234 apples. So here you want to take and write 234 apples. And here also one more box is there. How many apples are there? 71. Okay. So in the first box you want to write. See here, 234 apples. Okay. So here also one more apple they have given. So 71. So 71. Where you have to write? Yes. Here. See here. From the ones place you want to write 1 and in tens place you have to write 7. Okay, so 234, 71 below that you want to write. Now you can start adding these numbers. Okay, Kanna. Now see here, Kanna, apples. Okay, so apples we have written and you have to add. Okay, so as usual addition you have to do, Kanna. Here watermelons. So how many watermelons are there? See here. Here 42, here 260. So first you want to take and write the largest number 260. Below that the smallest number 42 you want to write it. And you want to add these two numbers. Okay, if you are adding you will be getting the answer 302 watermelons and pineapples. So like that pineapples and for mangoes you want to take and write. So for pineapples 452, 155. And for mangoes 325 and 46. So you want to take and write one below another and you want to do the addition. As usual addition. Okay, Kanna? Yes. Now see, Kanna, take page number 30 in your studio. Solve the problems in your notebook and match the faces. So you have to take rough note, Kanna. Okay, so take rough note and they have given the problems. Okay, so take rough note, Kanna. Okay, so you want to do the subtractions. Okay, so for this problem, you want to do the subtraction and find the answer. And for this sum also, you find the answer. Like that, you find the answer for these sums. See here, 1, 2, 3, 4. So, 4 sums you want to find the answer. For remaining, they have given the answers. Okay, so for 4 sums alone, you want to find the answer. And you want to match the fishes. Okay, see, Kanna. So, here one fish is there. Okay, so here another fish is there, same fish. And you want to find the answer for these two fishes. Because these fishes are same. Okay, so you want to match it. So, solve the problem and match the fishes. Okay. So you can do by yourself. Now see, Kanna, next we are going to see the PEP activity 8.7. Okay. Now see, Benny scores 457 points in a game. Okay. So Benny scores 457 points in a game. He makes an error and loses 67 points. How many points does he have now? Okay, so this is the total number of score. In that, how much he loses? Yes, 67. So what they are asking, how many points does he have now? So what, which operation you want to use, Kanna? See, what do I need to find? So what you have to find? Yes, you want to find the points what he have now. Okay, so that you have to take and write. So how many points does he have now? Now which operation will I use? Which operation, Kanna, we will use? Yes, very good, subtraction. Okay, so total score is this much and he loses this much. So losses means, yes, you want to do the subtraction. Okay, now see here, Kanna, they have given the space for you. Okay, so here you want to do the subtraction. Now see here, Kanna, so you have to take and write the total number of score 457. Okay, how much he loses? 67. Okay, so like this you have to take and write. And see, subtraction, 7 minus 7, 0. Okay, so from 5 you cannot subtract 6. Yes, so what you have to do? Yes, we want to borrow from the nearest place. Okay, so if you borrow 1, this tens place will become 15. And here the number will become 300. Okay, now 15 minus 6, 9. And this 3 as it is you have to take and write. Okay, so this is the answer. So how many points does he have now, Kanna? Yes, he is having 390 points. He have 390 points now. Okay, see here, Kanna. We use addition when there is an increase in the quantity. Okay, so when we will use addition, Kanna, when there is increase in the quantity. Increase means addition. Subtraction means decrease in the quantity. So decrease means subtraction. Okay, that you have to remember. Now see here, Kanna. Word problem, one question they have given. Bob has 126 shells. Okay, he picks 32 more on the beach. So he picks 32 more means additionally he is picking along with 126 shells. How many does he have in total? So total means what you have to do? Yes, we want to add these two numbers. Okay. So see the step one, Kanna. Read the problem and imagine it as a story. Okay, so read the problem well. And what is given, Kanna? What is given in the problem? Bob has 126 shells. He picks 32 more. Additionally, he is picking. So what is given? Bob has 126 shells. He picks 32 more on the beach. How many does he have in total? So what we want to find, what I need to find out means which operation you want to use. Total means addition. Okay. Yes. Take the next page, Kanna. See here. What is given? What is given? What I need to find out. Okay. See here. Number of shells Bob has 126. And number of shells Bob picks 32. Okay. What is the question they are asking? How much in total? Okay. So which operation you want to use? Addition. You want to put tick mark. And this is the working area. Working area you want to take and write the number. 126 below that 32 and you want to add these two numbers. So if you add these two numbers you will be getting the answer 158. So at the last you have to take and write, Kanna. Bob has 158 shells in total. Okay, at the last for all the word problems you want to take and write the answers like this. Now see, Kanna, next look deep activity 8.8. Okay, so this is also a home fun for you. So read the question and you can do by yourself. Okay, so Meena has collected 104 stamps and Reena has collected 92 stamps. How many stamps do they have in total? So total means you want to do the addition. So what is given? So number of stamps Meena collected, how much, Kanna? Yes, 104. Okay, so see, Meena collected 104, Reena collected 92. So Meena collected 104, here you want to write. Reena collected 92, here you want to write 92. How many stamps do they have in total? So total means you want to do the addition. So which operation, Kanna? Yes, absolutely plus. Okay, so you want to put the tick option for the plus symbol. And here you want to take and write the stamps, Kanna. Okay, so what is the Meena stamps, Kanna? 104. Reena, 92. Okay, so here you can draw the picture like stamps, Kanna. So they have given the space. Okay, so here you want to draw 104 stamps. Here you want to draw 92 stamps. You can draw. Okay, and then here you want to put the tick option for plus symbol. We are going to add. So how many Meena collected, Kanna? 104. And Reena, 92. So now you want to do the addition. Okay? Yes. So as usual, 4 plus 2, 6. And 0 plus 9, 9. And this one, as it is, you want to take and write. So totally 196 stamps they have. Okay? Now they give 23 stamps away to Sheena. So out of this, they are giving 23 stamps away. So let us see how many stamps they have now. So now you have to draw number of stamps Meena and Reena have. So both are having how much, Kanna? 196 stamps. Okay, and number of stamps they gave away to Sheena is 23. Yes, here 23. Okay, so now how many stamps do they have now? So they gave away. So gave away means which operation you will use? Either plus or minus. Yes, very good. Subtraction. Okay. Okay. So what is the total number of stamps Meena and Reena have? 196. Out of this, they are giving 23 away. Okay. So 23 they are giving to Sheena. So now what, which operation you want to use? Subtraction. So subtraction you want to do. Okay. So if you're subtracting, put minus symbol. Okay, because you are doing subtraction. So if you subtract means we'll be getting 173. Now how many stamps they have, Kana? 173. Okay. So like that you have to do the word problem. Now see, Kana, everyone take your companion book, page number 11. 8C is the home fund for you. See, this is also a word problem. 274 people came to watch the circus on Friday. Okay, 137 on Saturday and 520 on Sunday. How many people in all came to see the circus? So, how many people in all? All means you want to do the addition. Okay, so Friday this much people, Saturday this much and Sunday this much. So, in all these days, how many people came? So you want to take and write the step. Okay, so on Friday 274, on Saturday 137, on Sunday 520 people came. So whether you want to add or subtract? Yes, you want to add. So all means you want to add, put tick option and do the calculation. Okay, Kana, so complete this home fund and upload in the Kensi lab. Okay, Kana, we can see in the next session. Bye.